This morning, I was scrolling through Facebook groups and saw tons of questions about getting skewed engravings on the F1 Ultra. So I thought, why not make a quick video showing exactly how I line everything up on my own setup. In this video, I'll walk you through how I set up all kinds of shapes so they end up perfectly straight. Let's start with the trickiest one. This piece needs to be perfectly perpendicular to the machine, so it lines up parallel to the center axis. To get that orientation, I draw a thin rectangle, 200mm wide by 1mm tall, just as a reference line. I center it to the bed, lined with the lens and table, then it frame. That gives me a crisp line in the bed to which I align the corners of the diamond-shaped holes on my workpiece. Once that rectangle has done its job, I delete it. Next, I bring in the engraving design, which I group and position it. Now I'll use the camera to get it as close as I possibly can to where I want it. Remember, I'm not going to move the piece on the machine as it's already aligned with the back. So I'll need to move my design until it lines up with my workpiece. And use a temporary circle around the design that's the same size as the center part of my workpiece. Holding shift and arrowing it into perfect alignment with the inner circle on the workpiece without touching the piece ensures a flawless setup. Now let's move on to the dog tag. So what I normally do with the dog tag is I measure it. So mine, I know it measures 24mm by 42mm high. So that's very easy. All you need is a little block that's exactly the size of your dog tag. We'll set it to 42mm by 24. And now we need to make sure that our engraving will fit inside of it. Now group these layers, because if you now hit a line and it's not grouped, all your layers will align with each other and it'll be a mess. So it's grouped. We can just hit align center. So now if you were to frame this, you would get the perfect outline. But before we can frame it, we need to set the height. Now these little rings at the top, they can be a bit of a pain because it will push your dog tag a little bit out of alignment. It's not a big deal, but you can do it better. So I usually just take a scrap piece of 6mm MDF, which I know is perfectly flat, and I'll position it so that the tag's end will hang off of the MDF. Now you're ready to auto measure. So as you can see now, when you hit framing, you can now just simply position it so that it's inside of that rectangle. And when you're done framing, you leave everything alone and you just delete that rectangle. All right, so here we go. Let's get our engraving going. I am working on a different way of doing engravings that I actually just started testing. Once testing is done, I'll definitely share this as another video with you guys. I think it would actually make this a lot quicker and also a lot easier for a lot of beginners. So to do the shiny side, We do exactly the same thing, except for one small change. I like moving this stuff off-center so that it's not directly under my lens, as I'm afraid that it can reflect back into your lens and then damage your laser. So if the beam hits it at an angle, it will actually be deflected into your shield, which can be cleaned easily without damaging your laser head. Okay, so here you can see exactly what I'm talking about. You want that into your laser head? I don't. Okay, repeatability. So I make a jig whenever I can. This gives you great repeatability. So this, I can set up the file once. If I screw this jig back on, I can just place the dog tag or whatever I'm engraving in exactly the same spot each and every time. I've taken engravings like that, butterfly out, put it back, and then did the score line and was still perfectly aligned. So these type of jigs is going to be the most useful thing you will make for yourself. I pretty much leave this one on my Ultra all the time. I only take it off when I do other type of things, like when I put a cup jig or something on. You see these burn marks here? This is all from from the laser reflecting off of my workpiece. And the MDF seems to do a good job of actually absorbing it rather than burning. That's why I would use MDF for this if you made it. I wouldn't use something like plywood. I think it's more flammable. So you see, alignment, easy peasy. So I know that's going to be straight with my machine now. So now I just need to go and set up a file to actually correspond. Same story. The cut file I just put in there, use it for alignment. Align your writing to the center of that cut file. And then you adjust using your arrow keys, holding down shift, not holding down shift, however you like, until you get the perfect alignment. Now, this being shiny as well, I move it off to the side, and you'll see why. So now I need to make three different boards with three different text on it. But what's nice about this now, because I'm using a jig, I can just go and check the X and Y positioning on the page that's already correct, and I can repeat it by just typing it in. No alignment, nothing. You just do it, it will be right. Also, a little pro tip, this laser plastic that I'm using here, it's got a very shiny one side and the other side is black, because you do actually burn right through the shiny part into the black to get your ledger. So when I do the autofocusing, I actually just flip it over and use the black side, as the reflective stuff can really give you issues when you actually autofocus. Okay. Just like that, you've got three files all in the right positioning now. And now it's as easy as ungrouping it, double clicking your text and changing it to whatever you like. And just make sure it's centered again. You'll see all of them are lined up now, the same as the first one. There we go. And this game time is money. So the more time you can save, the more money you can make. Alright, so let's get to actually making one of these. And we'll check if I'm right, if it actually is aligned center. Okay, so because this is actually so reflective, you will see at the top it almost looks like it's not lining up. That's just it reflecting off of the material. So if I do something like this, I will use the left side and the bottom side for my alignment. I do know the outer one is the cut file that I use to cut this, so it'll be perfectly sized. Right, so moment of truth. Let's do the engraving and see where it ends up. Okay, and just as another side note, never, ever try and save money on your air extraction. Never. The gases that these machines give off is very harmful to you. So if you want to save money, you can save it anywhere else. Just don't try and do it on your air extraction. Get the best air extraction that you can get. In my opinion, venting outside is always going to be your best bet if you're not going to be poisoning someone else close by. If you do have to use a filter, factor in the pricing of those filter cartridges, because I found out the hard way very quickly that in South Africa, those things are prohibitively expensive. That's all I have for you this week. Hope you liked the video. If you don't mind, please subscribe to my channel, as it is the easiest free way to support me and my business, and is appreciated more than you will ever know. Till next time, stay well.